Hello and welcome to my Olympus workspace session. My name is Michael Gutmann and I would like to show you today the graphical user interface. After you open Olympus workspace, it looks like this. At the top you see the menu. As in all softwares, in the menu you find all the functionalities available in the software. However, using the graphical user interface is much more convenient. Underneath the menu, you find the icon bars. These icon bars are divided in different parts. For example, at the left-hand side, you find icons for importing and exporting images. These are followed by the tools available in Olympus Workspace. Here you find functions like stitching a software, making a time lapse, or printing your images. And you have also the possibility to make a slideshow to show the images in a gallery to your clients or to your family and friends. This is followed by an icon which looks like a camera. This is the update function of Olympus Workspace, with which you can update firmware of your camera and your lenses in case you have attached them to the computer. In the center, the icons are related to the area below. This is the gallery area, which can be customized in different ways. I prefer the way where you have the gallery underneath a preview, because then you can use the preview as judgment whether it is worth to edit an image or not. On the right hand side, the icons are for the windows which are available in the software in addition. So for example, you see here the filter. The filters are in the lower left corner and you can switch them on and off here. This also shows you the principle that icons which are highlighted in yellow are active and icons which are gray are not active. This is a concept of the whole software. Coming to the windows, on the left hand side you have the Explorer, which is your computer file system, and you can use to navigate there to your folder where the images you would like to edit are located. In my case it is Olympus Workspace demo folder, which is opened here and used for this demonstration. Then you find the section Olympus Capture. This is not active at the moment because Olympus Capture is not started. However, this section is also only available when you have Olympus Capture installed to your computer and will show then the images coming from Olympus Capture to Olympus Workspace as a preview. Underneath you find a section where you can find your collections. A collection is more or less a virtual folder for themes, which you can do by yourself. But this I will explain you in a different session about Olympus Workspace later on. Last but not least, on the left hand side you see the filter. With the filter you can decide whether you would like to see all images or only specific images, for example images which are rated then with more than 3 stars or which are marked with a special color mark, which is also quite useful when you have a lot of images in the gallery and you would like to concentrate on specific ones. Rating, you can give the images directly underneath. So for example, when I rate this as 3 images and I filter that, then I only see that one. Quite obvious. Then above the gallery you find additional icons which are related to the preview. So you can switch on off a grid, you can have highlight shadows and highlight warning, you can activate the information where your focus point have been. In my example it was not on the object, so that could be the reason why it's not 100% sharp. You can do different things, and as said, all the icons who are active are highlighted in yellow. So for example, when I zoom in one by one, then one by one is highlighted, or when I zoom out again, then the full screen icon is highlighted. The right section has also two windows. The first one is for edit. It's headed with edit and contains all edit possibilities of the software. The empty one is the star one, and this is the customized palette. Here you can put in your favorite functions from the other tabs that you don't have to go through the tabs all the time, just use one tab for your work. These functionalities I also will explain you in a second section, because it's also quite a lot of things to say about that. Then you have a section where you can save the settings you have done to one image, that's that, and you can copy these settings to other images or to a bunch of other images, so that you can easily transfer your edit from one image to others. Then we have a histogram available, and last but not least, all the EXIF information which are located in the file. So first of all information about camera, then all information about the image, all information in addition, so all the EXIF information. And you can also make notes to each image. So when you would like to make a note that you, for example, know where you have done the image, or whether it was a special occasion or something like that, this could be also saved to the image here. And out of these, you can do again a favorite tab where you have your favorite information in, that you don't have to scroll through all the four other tabs when you would like to see certain information. Before ending the session, I also would like to show you that the software is quite heavily customizable. So you can use also the software on two different screens. So for example, you would be able to use this preview on a second screen and the gallery on this screen. And you can arrange the different windows or tabs freely in the software. And all of the stuff you can move have dots at the top, and when you put them out, the software shows you where you can attach them again. So there are different places where they can be located, and of course when you have put them out, you can also put them to a different monitor if you would like to, which is quite powerful and an easy way to customize your software for your needs. I hope you liked this session. I'm already at the end. If so, please give me a thumb up and subscribe to this channel. And I hope I will see you next time, and wish you a nice evening. Bye bye.